Good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fit and fine and you are taking all the precautions. Yes, again, the school is off till 30th of November. Let's see what will happen after that. But make sure you will keep all the precautions required to save us from this corona situation. Now, okay, let's come back. Chapter number 4, major landforms. And this we have already discussed that in India or even in the world, there are different kinds of landforms. Some parts have mountains, some parts have plateaus, some parts have rivers, okay, different kinds of valleys. So all these are different landforms. And these landforms are formed by a process called as weathering and erosion. What is weathering? What is erosion? We have already discussed that in detail. Now, erosion purposes or the weathering processes, or you can say all the major landforms are formed by the work of a river, by a work of sea waves, by the work of wind, by the work of glaciers. So we will start that with by the work of rivers.
Work of a river. Running water is perhaps the most powerful agent of erosion. Rain causes some water to flow in small streams so it can be joined together to form a river. Some rainwater evaporates and the rest of it sweeps underground. Source is a term used for a place from where the river originates. Sea, lake and ocean are large water bodies in which a river falls. Mouth is the term used for the place where the river joins another water body. River basin is an area which is drained by the river and its tributaries.
So, these three concepts about mouth, river basin and the source. We have already discussed that source is the place from where the river originates. Mouth is a place where a big river meets some another big water body. For example, like Ganga meets at the mouth of Bay of Bengal. So drain out to the Bengal and the point where this both meets are called as the mouth of the river. Then river basin, the different area by the major river and its tributaries, water carrying canals, rivers, all those makes the river basin.
The three ways by which running water carries out its work are: A. Eroded material is transported by running water. B. It erodes the rock over which it flows. C. The transported material is also deposited by it. The function of a river varies with the volume of water it carries. The slope of a riverbed also plays a vital role. In hilly regions or in the mountains, due to the steep slope of land, the river carries a small volume of water. Due to narrow stream, it flows swiftly with enormous erosive power, forming number of landforms. The most common landform which is formed by rivers is V-shaped valley. Gorge is a very deep and narrow valley. It is formed when a river erodes vertically through hard rocks.
So you will find that when river, generally all the rivers originate from mountain areas, okay, like Ganga, Brahmaputra, Indus, Satluj, it originates from Himalayas. Now you will find that when it comes from the Himalayas to down plain, there is a very steep slope, okay, the water will flow from the upward side to the downward side, resulting into a lot of weathering activities, erosional activities. Why? Yes, wear and tear of rocks, as well as making very deep valleys, some around V shapes are generally. You will find that mountains, and within the mountains there is a river flowing from that area. So that kind of mountains or that kind of valleys are called as the V shaped valleys.
This valley is shaped like the letter I, and therefore it is called an I shaped valley. A waterfall is formed when the water of the river falls almost vertically down a steep valley side. Sudden break in the landform due to faulting is also responsible in the formation of a waterfall.
So waterfall, we all know that in Hindi it is called as jharna. Now waterfalls are formed when there's a sudden fall of water coming from the mountain region. There is no there is a land which is 100 or 200 meter deep, and the water directly, yes, you can see in the picture number 3, that is directly going down to that areas. Now that is one of the condition. The other conditions can be the sudden break in the landforms due to the faulting is also responsible for the formation of the waterfall. Now what is faulting? First of all, you should know what is faulting. Faulting is basically a pressure, a stress developed in the land surface, which ultimately leads to the cracks in the land and forming a one big areas, one slow areas, okay, one deep areas, one up area, one deep areas, due to the stresses developed in the landforms. So that areas also ultimately results into the waterfalls in that region.
Suddenly, the slope of the riverbed drops and waterfall is formed. In Africa, the Victoria Falls on River Zambezi is the best example of such a waterfall. The other waterfall includes Angel Falls in Venezuela in South America.
Angel Falls in Venezuela is one of the highest waterfall in the world. Okay, so Venezuela is a country in South America. So it's a country in a South America.
And Niagara Falls in North America. And Jog Falls at Karnataka.
So see, this is the Karnataka, our India site, called as Jog Falls in Karnataka. A very beautiful
tuck in India. Rapid is a term given to the steep sloping segment of the swift flowing river. On entering the plain, the flow of the river is no longer swift. Due to continuous erosion, meanders are formed when the flow.
So what is, see, you should remember every terminology related to the rivers. Source, river basin, mouth, then meander. So what is meander? This snake-like structure, you see, the snake-like structure formed by the, you can say, the river due to some, you can say, this area maybe have hard rocks, this area have a soft rocks. So soft rocks will be eroded, resulting into this snake-like structure is called as meander. So meanders are formed when the floor of the river basin widens.
Floor of the river valley widens. The river twists and turns to form loops and large bends. The meandering loops become almost circular due to continuous erosion and deposition and come very close to each other. After some time, the strip of land is cut by the river in two loops, taking a straight course. The circular loop is completely cut off from the main channel, and this results in the formation of an oxbow lake.
So here you will see in this picture that, see, this is the river now. See, this is the river now. This is the flow of the river. Okay. But you will find that there is one another body, this body, which is separated by the, you can say, main river course. But this was some time back, this was the part of the main river, but due to the erosional depositional processes of river, this area actually cut off from the river side, formed the circular, okay, flow, and this formed a lake generally called as Oxbow Lake. So yes, you will find that it's like a oxbow structure, which you generally find ox ke niche, ghode ke niche. Yes, the plate work done for their, yes, to protect their needles and all those. So Oxbow Lake, this was related to the lake erosional activity.
Most of the floods are caused in rainy season as the water spills over the banks, causing floods. On receding, this water leaves behind alluvial deposits over a large area on both sides of the river. This deposited alluvium forms a relatively flat region known as a floodplain. Deposition is in abundant quantity near the river channels. So, after many floods, these deposits pile up along the banks of the river and form raised embankments. These embankments are termed as natural levees. The river ends at the river mouth. On reaching...
So, you will find that all these sediments which are good in, you can say, nutrients, after coming from the mountain sides, reaching the valley sides and then to the plain areas, all the sediments get deposited near to the flood plains, resulting into the formation of one of the fertile lands of the world and the soil called as the alluvial soils. Ganga also do the same thing. Ganga, on reaching the northern plain areas, reaching the plain areas in India, it deposit the alluvial soil, that sediments which are very good for cultivation and agriculture purposes. And you will find that India ki one of the biggest agriculture areas are under that northern plain region. So rivers play a very much important role. Ek time ke baad, the sediments are deposits in such sediments are deposited in such a way that it will build like a natural protections on the river both end side called as the natural levees. Okay.
Reaching its mouth, the river carries large volume of alluvium and water. In the wide river channel, the excess load is deposited as sandbars. The main channel is divided into several channels. These several channels are known as distributaries. The most distinctive feature formed in this stage of the river is the delta. A delta is a depositional landform formed by a network of distributaries, generally due to deposition of sediment by the respective river. The shape of the delta is triangular. The Ganga-Brahmaputra Delta of India is the largest delta in the world. Major Indian rivers which drain in Bay of Bengal form deltas at their mouths. Rivers which drain into the Arabian Sea do not form deltas because most of the rivers are short and cannot accumulate enough sediments to build deltas.
So what's happened at the end of the mouth of the river? That sediments brought by the rivers started depositing near to the mouth of the river. Now, as it build pressure, that results into the different sides, different channels of the rivers reaching to the Bay of Bengal or to the ocean water body. Now, don't confuse tributaries with distributaries. So, tributaries are the small rivers which meets the main rivers and it flow till the end of the river drain out to a ocean. Distributaries are formed after the heavy deposition of the sediments near to the mouth, resulting into the different channels at the end of the system. So tributaries join main river, but in distributaries the main river is again distributed to many channels, and the system which forms at the end of the, you can say, mouth is called as delta, which is generally triangular in shape. It also have some other shapes, but Ganga Brahmaputra Delta, which forms in the Kolkata to the Bangladesh side also, is the world largest delta, which even supports a very good vegetation plus our national animal, that is the Royal Bengal Tiger.
Work of sea waves.
So we have completed the work of rivers. I hope it is clear to you. Rivers form different kinds of landforms like valleys, plains, you can say deltas. All those comes under the work of a river. Now we will see the work of a sea wave.
In coastal areas, the sea is constantly eroding the old landforms and creating new ones. Erosional and depositional work is performed by seawater with the help of sea waves. Currents, Tides and storms also help in it. Even hard rocks are broken down by the sea wave colliding in the coast.
So you will find that generally sea waves means tides, currents, all this, they come in a very big strength and it will erode the or it will deposit the sands forming the beautiful beaches of the world, or it can lead even to the cliff by eroding the hard rocks present at the end of the landmass. So overall, sea in the form of waves and tides also put pressure, result into the erosions of the land areas and formation of different kinds of landforms.
Rock material is carried away by receding waves. This rock material present in sea water causes the erosion of landforms against which it crashes. This is known as marine deposition or marine erosion. Sea cliffs are formed when waves crash against a high rocky coast near the base.
So see, this is the one kind of landforms. It is called as, from here to here you will see this area, okay? Ye aur pura area, this comes under the cliff. I hope you all know what is cliff, okay? So this is cliff. This is how this is the end of the landmass. This is the end of the landmass and the starting of the sea waterway. So erosional activities also formed cliff due to the strong waves striking this area.
The rocks are eroded near the base. With the passage of time, the rocks above the hollowed out part collapse. It leaves behind a steep wall of rock facing the sea. This is known as sea cliffs.
So you will see what happening, that the water will strike down, okay? The water will strike here and it will erode this area. Ultimately, it will create a hollow system and the upper part of this soil will ultimately drops into the oceans. That is how the cliff actually formed. Only the hard rocks will remain standing and other rocks will be result into the erosion, and this will end that cycle.
Sea waves create a thorough passage when a headland projecting into a sea is dashed. This passage is called sea arc. It leaves behind a pillar of rocks standing in the open water. When the roof of sea arc is further eroded, it collapses.
So this is what the sea arc is. Means the river, this is the arc, Banera, you can see that this is strong rock and some rock from here eroded forming into the arc and into the hollowness of the areas. That is called as the sea rock, sea arc.
These are termed as stacks. Sandbars are formed when the broken rock materials are deposited on the seafloor near the coast. Sediments like pebbles and sand are deposited in seawater along the coast. They include material produced by marine erosion and brought by rivers. A beach is formed in due course of time from all these deposits. Sometimes the seawater is trapped between the sandbars and the coast. As a result, a lagoon is formed, which is partially enclosed lake.
So what is sea? Beautiful beaches are also formed, but sometimes the sea waters comes to the depression some areas in the landmass, and that water is cut off from the main surface of the sea or main part of the sea. So that cut off water is called as the lagoons. And
Chilka Lake or the Chilika Lake in Odisha is the largest lagoon in India.
Okay.
Work of moving ice.
So you have seen that work of sea waves results into the formation of sea cliffs, sea arcs, stacks, beaches, lagoons. Chilka Lake or Chilika Lake, which is in Odisha, is one of the largest lake in India, which is a lagoon actually. It's a water cut off from the sea, which was actually the part of the sea sometimes, but it is not now. But it's like Chilika Lake that support a very huge, good numbers of natural vegetations and the wildlife animals during that areas. And you will find that Chilika Lake is, and near to that is Bhitarkanika, one of the areas where you can say are the breeding sites of turtles, which come to India every year, lay their eggs, and that area is protected for this turtles only. Okay, now let's see the next point, work of a moving ice.
Snowfields are formed by the snow which falls in high latitudes and heights. They lie above the snow line. A glacier is a river of snow and ice that moves out very slowly from the snow fields. It may move at the rate of only a few meters a day. The main work of the glacier is transportation.
So you will see that the big ice mountains, which are we called as glaciers, that also moves. Wo bhi move karte hain. And that can be a very few meters in a day, but ultimately this glacier results into the erosion process. These glaciers help in the transportation process and deposition process. So glaciers which moves are also important for erosion, transportation and deposition process.
Erosion and deposition. A glacier can alter as well as totally remove the existing landforms, creating completely new and different landforms. When a glacier passes through a valley, the floor and sides of the valley are eroded by the rock pieces present in the glacier. Thus, the floor becomes flat and sides become steep. This type of valley is called U-shaped valley. Among the slope of a mountain, the glacier carves out deep hollows. It develops an armchair-like depression which is known as a creek.
See, this area, okay, this you can see, the erosion formed by the glacier is this area, okay, ye jo area hai, this downward areas, okay, is called as creek. This area is called as creek. Why? Because due to the depression, this area has lowered and all the ice will come down to this place. And glaciers, due to the erosion process, results into the U-shaped valley. Okay, it results to the U-shaped valleys. Now,
the depression is filled up with water and forms a lake when glacial ice melts. This lake is known as Tarn.
So this depression, creek mein jo depression hai, the water, so the ice can melt and results into a beautiful formation of a lake which is called as the Kirk Lake or the Tarn. Okay?
The capacity of glacier to carry load is reduced when it starts melting. Hence, it deposits the rock material on the floor and side of the valley. These deposits form glacial moraines.
So, we will continue from here. I think there is a disturbance at the back. So, we will continue from here tomorrow. But see, the capacity of the glaciers to carry load is reduced when it starts melting. And this rock materials deposit forms are called as the glacial moraine. We will discuss that in details tomorrow.